Hello and welcome to Adevărul Financiar Live, our weekly show. We have here today Dimitris Raptis, Deputy CEO and Chief Investment Officer of Global Wealth, the biggest office developer in Romania. Hello.
Hello, thank you very much for the invitation.
Dimitris, how does it feel when you wake up in the morning knowing that Global Wealth, the company you manage, is the biggest office building developer in Romania and also in Poland?
It feels great. For us, it's obviously it doesn't feel great just because we are the biggest and the largest. First of all, as in any, let's say, job. The most important thing is the people that you work with. So we have a fantastic team of people both here in Bucharest as well as in Warsaw. We're more than 200 people now across both markets. So that's the first and the most important thing. But also it feels great because we're part of creating something beautiful. We like creativity. We like effectively when we invest in those markets, seeing the effects of our investment. Currently we have about 1 million square meters, actually more than 1 million square meters across both Romania and Poland, and we have more than 200,000 people working and visiting our properties on a daily basis. So it's this, basically we are seeing that basically we are creating a community within our properties, and this gives us great satisfaction.
And still you plan more investments in Romania, as far as I know.
Yes, correct. In both markets, of course. In Romania, of course, this is where we started from. We continue to believe a lot in the potential and the growth of the local market. So we still have ambitious investment plans for the near to medium term.
You will invest only in office buildings or also in other industries?
It's mainly offices. More than 80% of our portfolio is offices. Here in Romania, however, we have a very good logistics, light industrial component. We have a very nice hub in Timișoara, very near the airport, called Timișoara Airport Park. We also have the largest distribution facility of Renault outside of France in Pitești, and we're looking actually to further expand the logistics exposure and operations we have in Romania. We have recently actually rebranded our logistics platform under the name of Global Logistics, and we have further investment plans in this market segment as well.
The logistic business will be as big as the office building is now?
No. It will never become as big. We'll always be primarily an office investor and a developer. But we want to further expand and grow our logistics platform as well.
And I know that you said at some point that you'd be interested in also investing in hotel industry, which is very different from real estate industry.
Not really. I mean, again, we're very focused on what we do, and this is, I think, one of the key success factors over the last several years. We don't want to expand in many different market segments or in many different geographies. So we're very focused on Romania and Poland. As far as hotels are concerned, we may, do the odd investment either here in Romania or in Poland, but this will be more on an exceptional basis if we see an opportunity which makes a lot of sense. Both markets have, we believe, offer potential in this market segment, but it will be much more on an opportunistic basis rather than, try to substantially develop a different market segment.
But what are the differences between the Romanian market and the Polish market?
Let me start actually with just taking a bit on the reverse side. What both markets share in common? Basically, they are, first of all, Poland and Romania are the largest countries and economies in the Broad Sea region. They have both of them. They have a young, dynamic population speaking very good English and other foreign languages. Very well skilled workforce. Very good universities, which basically has attracted a lot of multinationals in both markets to invest and expand, mainly in what we call in the shared services and BPO sectors. Obviously, you know, relatively or much lower actually cost of labor compared to Western Europe, and also a relatively low and actually stable tax environment as well. So these are more or less the main common themes we see across both markets. In terms of differences, the main one, of course, Poland is a much more developed, much more mature. It's a deeper, much more liquid market. In Poland, you have also a very, very strong presence of regional cities. So I would say Poland, together with Germany, are the only countries in Europe which have such strong regional cities presence. Obviously, you have this here in Romania as well, with cities like Cluj, Timișoara, Iași, and the like. But it's the scale is much less compared to Poland. And the other, I would say, main difference we have noticed is infrastructure. Poland is really very advanced. They have been very, very successful in utilizing, you know, especially European Union funds, grants, and subsidies in order to develop their, you know, transport infrastructure, roads, railways, metro, and its airports. So it's a very, overall, it's very, very modern and up to date. Romania, unfortunately, as we know, lags behind in this respect, and I would say this is one of the things that the country should and can do better going forward. The other thing, both countries, they, because there's a lot of demand from these multinationals for well-skilled employees. They have very low unemployment rates, which creates obviously a lot of competition, and it's not easy to find these days good and well-skilled employees. Poland is a little bit more fortunate compared to Romania in the sense that it benefits from immigration from the east, from Ukraine. There are more than 1 million Ukrainians now basically living and working in Poland. Whereas here in Romania, you don't have this side benefit.
Mm-hmm. But the Polish market, I assume, is much more competitive than the Romanian one, or not?
It is, absolutely. It's a bigger market, and as a result, it's a deeper market. It's more mature and more liquid, and as a result, much more competitive as well. As far as we are concerned, the opportunity we have capitalized on and the niche we have been able to find in both markets, both Romania and Poland, is that we are the only, office investor and developer, of course, who is very much, you know, hands-on asset management focused. So most of the players in this region, they are what I call asset recyclers. So effectively, they enter, they buy a project, whether it's a land to be developed, or a standing office building with a view to sell, either in the near term or in the medium term.
But we buy, build and don't sell.
Exactly, we buy or we build exactly with the intention to hold.
To hold for how long?
To hold for many years. We don't have, a fixed investment horizon. We're a publicly listed company, and we operate as many, European and international real estate investment companies, where effectively we are delivering to our shareholders a growing and sustainable dividend stream, as well as, of course, in our case, because we're in a growing market, capital appreciation from our investments.
How many buildings do you own now?
Across both markets, we have more than 50 investments. Buildings, I mean, one investment could be more than one building, but let's say we have about 52, 53, I think, investments.
And you don't plan any exit? You want to keep them all?
For now, yes. Listen, because the markets are still very good. There are investment opportunities that make sense, at least for us, in both markets. In Romania, I would say in the last 18, 24 months, we have been mostly focused on developing projects, offices, and logistics. Whereas in Poland, so far we have been focused on buying income-producing assets.
And how many new buildings we will see in Bucharest in the next 2 years?
You mean from us or generally
speaking? From you, yes, of course.
I cannot say that. I don't know. I mean, what I can tell you is that from the projects we have in our portfolio, we have a couple of active developments. We are close to finalizing the last building of a Global Wealth Campus project, actually very close to your offices here next door, which is basically a very successful office campus project and the largest office campus project in Romania. We recently, of course, delivered Renault Business Connect, which is the new, let's say, headquarters and the research and development center of Group Renault Dacia, the largest build-to-suit office development and leasing transaction in Romania, close to 50,000 square meters. We have started works on Global Wealth Square, which is basically the last remaining land plot on the Gara Herastrau road, and this should be delivered Q1 next year. We have a number of other logistics projects currently under development, both in Timișoara and, as recently announced, within the Bucharest Ring Road in Chitila. So this is basically it's an ongoing process. And whenever we find, investment opportunities that make sense, we'll keep on investing.
Who is your largest tenant?
In the largest tenant in our portfolio today is Renault Dacia.
And Renault. Most of your tenants, I assume, they are from what industries? IT?
Automotive, of course, because not, aside from Renault, we have other automotive tenants in our logistics projects in Timișoara, because, right, as you may know, Timișoara is a large, automotive hub. But as far as the rest are concerned, is mostly, IT, telecommunications, shared services, BPO,
which is basically companies.
Yes, more than 85-90% is multinational companies, correct.
And what do they want nowadays? Because I know the trends in...
That's a very good question, and this is basically, there is a growing shift, in our in our industry. Technology is a major disrupting force for everyone, of course, in our daily lives. So of course, real estate could be no exception. Employees these days are not just happy and satisfied with having a good salary and working in a nice, comfortable working environment. They want much more. They want their buildings to offer additional, concierge type services. They want electric cars. They want scooters. They want bike stations. But most importantly, what they're seeking for is to interact and to connect, not only with their colleagues in the same office, but also within with other, people that work or visit the property. So we currently, one of our key strategic aims and one of our key, areas of focus in our strategy is how we can connect workers, employees more closely, and how we can effectively build communities. This is a key word that basically a key. This is a feeling that that effectively employees want to experience these days, and we do this through a number of initiatives in our properties. We organize for the last, I would say, 12 months or so here in Bucharest, the Global World Art and Tech District, with many, let's say, art and technology related events and concerts. We introduced in a number of our properties co-working facilities, which is again another, let's say, trend in our industry, and we'll be launching very soon our own proprietary Global Wealth application within our properties. Initially, with some basic features in terms of accessing the building, controlling the clima, booking meeting rooms, and the like, and then going forward in the next phases of its development, offering more types of let's say these concierge type of services, ordering coffee, food, taxi. So this is basically a key feature of our strategy going forward.
So this app will be an app for the people working in all your buildings?
Working and visitors as well. Because, for example...
But do you have many visitors in the buildings?
As I said, between employees and visitors within our buildings across both countries, of course, we have some 200,000 people every day. So it's a big community.
Yeah, it will be a bigger community also.
Yes, and as we grow, of course, we'll become bigger, sure.
But you invested in this app because the tenants asked you to do it, or because PropTech is a very important trend in real estate?
It's a little bit of both, but I think it's more the latter. And we're great believers in technology. I mean, the other thing that we do that I didn't mention before is that we have started investing here in Romania in a number of technology-related VC funds, and the aim there is twofold: one, for us to gain knowledge and to be ahead of the curve in all the latest technological trends, but also using this opportunity and gathering effectively the investee companies of these funds around our properties, and creating tech hubs where all these very smart young people, young entrepreneurs, young engineers will connect, meet, interact, and exchange ideas.
So you will invest even more in PropTech?
Sure. Yes.
In apps or in funds or in
both,
startups?
Both in our proprietary Global Growth application, as well as in VC funds, or potentially even directly in some startups too.
What other trends did you notice in the real estate industry?
Well, I think this is the main trend, as I have been talking so far. Again. You have to. I mean, we are following what employees and the effectively millennials want these days. So, and a change we have noticed is that nowadays it is them who dictate the type of working and environment that they would like to work. It's not so much the older model where the senior management, the CEO of a large multinational saying, oh, I want to be in that building for XYZ reasons. Now, effectively, because also the employment market is so competitive, employees effectively dictate and demand the type of office working environment that they want. And this is the type of environment that they want is the one I just described, an environment where they're able to mingle, interact, connect, use technology, exchange ideas, and brainstorm not just with other colleagues, but also with a broader community that effectively passes through the building on a daily basis.
Unfortunately, we have to end our show today here. Thank you very much for joining us, Dimitris Stavris, Global Wealth.
Pleasure. Thank you very much. Thank you. We'll be right back.